for our tour of Pampangan food is Everybody's Café, which has become a favorite food stop since Benito and Carmen Santos put it up in 1946. Although well known for their offerings of the usual Pampangan delicacies, it also has exotic offerings. Tapang halabaw, adobong camaru, stuffed betute or frogs, and of course there is puro, served with fresh mustaza leaves. But everybody's favorite in Everybody's Café is the mulkon. It is ground pork mixed with chorizos and duck eggs, and then wrapped in utusan salad and cooked, I understand, very slowly for 6 hours. Here to share with us some of their recipes and also a lot of stories about Pampangan food are Pette and Pocholo. Good afternoon. Thank you very much for having us here. Thank you. Thank you for sharing what you will share with us about your food. These are camaro.
Camaro.
Yes. And these are.
Those are the native products.
These are native products.
People are asking us if there are other kind of cooking or preparations that are good, that's good for the camaro. We almost tell them that this is the best way to serve the camaro. Now smell the adobo.
Yes.
It smells like vinegar evaporating.
Wow, that's wonderful.
There's the cricket.
Product is the camaro, saute, and tomatoes. Maybe I should.
You should try one.
Truly good.
Fully grown. The fully grown are as big as that.
Ooh. And you don't serve those?
We don't serve them.
Why not?
Maybe they're the mother frogs.
Ah, so you want them.
Yeah, that will be something in particular.
So now with the meat turned steak. I always season in increments, so put pepper first. It's okay if you put a lot of pepper because it's more spicy that way. You mix it. And here's for the added taste. We put vinegar. concern about vinegar? Let me let the acid of the vinegar evaporate before we mix the stock.
When they say cook or else the vinegar gets
heal out. You can still taste the vinegar. So there, you can actually smell it.
Yeah. Like spending this most wonderful time of the year in the Christmas capital of the Philippines. And nothing in Pampanga symbolizes Christmas like its giant lanterns crafted by artisans, some reaching up 40 feet in diameter and making use of as many as 1,660 lights. The first lantern festival was held in 1938 in honor of President Manuel Quezon, who had made Arayat his rest area and converted Mount Arayat into a tourist resort. To show their gratitude, the people of San Fernando held the Christmas Lantern Contest to honor the first family. Today, the Giant Lantern Festival is held annually every third week of December, parade of ornate and cleverly illuminated lanterns. It is in this workshop of Kong Roland and Aching Ren, Kimbao, that we end this episode of My City, My SM, My Cuisine in Pampanga. We would like to thank them. And of course, heartfelt thanks and gratitude to the Lazatins, Councilor Jimmy, Clarita, Marco, and Aching Perla, their cook, who showed us how to do proper food. I'd also like to thank Pette and Poch Jorolan, and of course, Chef Lillian Borromeo. Thank you very much. We hope you enjoyed the recipes as much as we enjoyed tasting the food. Thank you, and we expect to see you when My City, My Air, My Cuisine goes to Cebu next month. Merry Christmas.